Hi guys, welcome to my home studio tour. We are in my audio recording office right now, and I'm also going to show you my video editing setup, which I have in a separate room. So here we go. Okay guys, let's start on this side of the room. So we have this beautiful cello. This is Snow Guo, $170 on Amazon, which you guys have seen in a lot of probably my other music videos. I gave it to a friend of mine, David Warner, who lives in Vegas, and he sent me a Facebook message the other day saying, "Hey Tina, check out what I did to the cello." He stuck on 40,000 crystals, took him 80 hours, and so I said, I know I gave you the cello, but can I have it back just to borrow it? So I just shot my new music video for The Last Samurai. Watch out for the video. This was featured in that. I have my Harvard Business School Online Negotiation Mastery Certificate. It was a really fun course that I did during COVID, just because I was bored and I thought learning how to negotiate would be fun. So this TCL TV, I don't even know how big it is. I think it's 55, maybe 60 inches. I use it as a secondary screen. Right now I have it mirroring my main setup here. This computer is an iMac Pro, but usually what I do is I actually use it as a sheet music reader to save on paper and printing costs. So I'll drag the sheet music for whatever sessions I'm doing, if there is sheet music, and read it off of there. The microphone, I have a ton of different microphones from SE Electronics, but this is the RNT, amazing microphone. So I'll pull it out to here, and then I will be sitting in about this position, if you can see me, this position right here. So I'm able to edit or kind of like, you know, control Logic from over here. And I'm looking at the sheet music this way. And if you remember from my 2016 studio walkthrough, I have almost all the exact same things. So the panels, I don't know if you can see that, they're kind of hidden behind the TV. These are the ClearSonic Sorber panels. So they open up and they kind of stand up, so you can make kind of a makeshift recording booth. So if it gets a little bit noisy, and sometimes it does get noisy here because there is a glass door that leads out to the front yard. I'm here in West Hollywood, and it's a pretty busy area, so I'll kind of like, you know, box myself in. Oh, I have upgraded though. I actually have speakers now. So these are the Karaoke Rocket 8s in white, and so I use those to, I don't know, I guess listen to my mixes. And for recording, I also use KRK headphones. They are the 8400, KNS 8400. They're great. And my keyboard is down here. I have it on, let me move this. I have it on wheels. So this desk, actually, most of the time I work standing up. It's an uplift desk. I absolutely love it. And then my keyboard is an M Audio Hammer 88. So it is weighted and it feels pretty, I mean, not super similar, but pretty similar to actual real keyboard. And the stand, I'm not going to bring it up right now, but the stand does go up and down so I can, you know, play and program stuff while standing up. And this desk goes really, really high. Why I would want it this high, I don't know, but and it goes all the way down. Oh, this microphone was a Christmas gift from last year, also from SE, and look, it has my name on it. I thought that was cool. I don't know if you can see it, but yay. Okay, so when I stand, this is actually new. I just got this. It's also from Uplift. So I stand on it and it's just kind of nice to be able to, can you see that a little bit? Yeah. Joel is filming, by the way. Hi, Joel. I guess you can't turn it around, right? So you can stand here. You can stand over here. You can stand in the middle. I don't know. I just think it's really fun to have different standing options. And then also this chair is really cool because, look, it kind of like tilts. And you can, I don't know, I kind of lean forward on it a little bit. I don't know about you guys, but if I'm like sitting in one place for too long, it's just, my body just starts feeling weird, so I like to constantly move around, and this makes it really easy to move around. So there is that. And then I have my iPad here. Sometimes I use it maybe for reference for video if I'm doing something to picture, so I'll actually have the video up here. And then my interface now is an Apollo from UA, from Universal Audio. It's amazing. So I have that routed around the back to my microphone over there, and when I record electric cello, I plug it into usually this one, but you can actually do two inputs at the same time. And randomly, in this box, we have a real meteorite, which is a gift from my friend Don. Thanks, Don. Okay, and then let's move over here. This is my Helix LT. You guys have probably seen it. It's my pedal board that I use for all live performances. When I record in Logic, I use the Helix Native plugin, so it's all the same sounds. And if you want to check out the exact sounds that I use, I actually, if you Google the Helix Hour, I gave away all of my sounds. So if you happen to have a Helix, you can play around with my settings that I use with the electric cello. And then here I have my, my YouTube button, a Grammy loser medallion, Grammy nomination, but I call it Grammy loser medallion, for my album with Peter Kater called Inner Passion. It was nominated for Best New Age Album in 2016. A picture from Hans Zimmer Live. We have a new instrument that I just had made. It is a Viking style harp. My new project for 2023 is called The Water Phoenix, and it's a blend of ancient tribal Chinese music and tribal Nordic, like Viking music. I don't know why, I'm just obsessed with like Viking music, so I'm blending the two together. So I had a bunch of like random instruments made, and this is one of them. And then I have some of my other Grammy certificates. This was for Dunkirk with Hans Zimmer and Inception. And over here, let's see, Sherlock Holmes, Lion King, Journey with Austin Wintry, the video game. And then if we come over here, I love this picture. It's one of my favorites. It's a Picasso lithograph, and it's an orgy with a, how do you say this? Minotaur, or something. A dude with a bullhead. Yeah, I thought that was cool. And then here we have a picture of my boyfriend Harley and I as cyborgs. That's pretty much a run through of my audio recording setup here. Let's move over outside into the rest of the house, and I'll show you where I edit video. Okay, so here is my video setup. Ta-da! Here we have another uplift desk. Very uplifting. So I usually work standing up. This is a 35 inch widescreen LG curved monitor. And here we have two MacBook Pros. So I have my editing program, which is Final Cut, running from this computer. These are exciting. These are new KRK monitors, and they're meant for travel, but they're amazing. They're also Bluetooth, which is super fun. So sometimes when I practice, I can just run backing tracks off of my phone or the computer or whatnot. So this is actually a little sneak peek of some of the footage from my new Last Samurai video. Ta-da! And then here I will use this for, I don't know, maybe if I want to move the video over, or if I'm editing video for like Instagram or something, or something that you want vertical, I'll have it on this screen. What else do we have here? Oh, let's look at my crystals. Can you see that? Isn't it pretty? I got it at a crystal shop in Vegas. This, and then we have a whole collection of crystals here. This is a very pretty amethyst that my friend Jen gave to me, and this is a quartz. Okay, Tina, we're not selling crystals. Okay, so here's some of my crystals, and then this amazing picture frame. It was a birthday gift from my little brother David. It shows Pizza and Bagel eating their favorite pizza treats from a doggy shop in Vegas. Okay, so all right, these are the different standing options. So one, I stand on the ground like a normal person. All right, next option, let's try not to fall on camera. This would be embarrassing. Okay, so we have this new wobble board from Uplift. Okay, are you ready? Am I ready? So I just stand here and then you just kind of balance and I don't know, you're like working out your core. Well, and editing and working. Oh, I think things go a little higher. So we have this and then we have another chair from Uplift. This is more like a donut style. See how it like, kind of curves in the middle? So it's not as wobbly. The base doesn't move, but it's great because you can make it higher and then you can move this down. So this is my setup here. Yeah, it's pretty basic, just Final Cut. I have, this is 4K footage, so I have it running off of a hard drive, which is hidden behind the picture frame, right here, that I got on sale on Amazon, Black Friday, 2 terabytes. Oh, I also have an Amazon list. I'll put the link below. You guys can check it out of all, basically my entire life is from Amazon, including this shirt, this watch pan, the watch cover thing, the shorts, yeah, everything. Okay. Thank you guys so much for watching. I just wanted to give a huge special thank you to my Patreon patrons who make these videos possible and also my music videos. And I wanted to give a special shout out to my sponsors, my gold sponsors and my diamond sponsors, Brian Fox, Don Morris, Jerry Schultz, Carl Callwood, hi Carl, James D. Hall, Ralph Van Dellen, Davis Shaw, and Andy Bartschy. I'm so sorry if I'm saying your name incorrectly. Please write to me and scold me for that. So if you guys want to check it out, I'm also on Patreon. I really appreciate it, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye. Oh, wait, not bye. I want to introduce you to my friend Joel, who is the man behind the camera. You want to say hi?
Hello, everybody.
All right, guys, that's it for now. I'll see you soon. Oh, God. What was that? You got that camera?
Yes, sir.
Oh, my God. It's perfect. Oh, by the way, this is Harley. Say hi. Oh, pizza. She's really sweet. She's just so timid.